loves. I hope everybody is safe, happy, healthy, and doing well. So guys, we're just going to do a super quick intro. If you guys are interested in crystals to help clear the chakras, anxiety, depression, you could visit Kim K Crystals. The link for her website is below, and she also does Facebook Lives a couple times a week, which are really awesome. All that info is below. Recommended readers are also below. We're going to be starting the giveaways again, okay? So I had to stop that for a couple months, but we're going to be starting up again. So the winners will be announced at the beginning of the month, okay? So be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. In the description box below, you're going to see a list of everything that I give away every month. And all you have to do is go to the comment section and hashtag what you would like to win, okay? And winners will be announced at the beginning of every month. What else do I want to tell you guys? Live readings with me or video readings with me. So I will be going on live and doing live question readings at least a few times a week. Or you can book a reading with me through my website, which is listed below. Okay. And last but not least, guys, when leaving a comment, if you have something negative that you would like to say about the reading, you are more than welcome to drop a comment. Just please be aware that as a reader, it doesn't really affect me because, you know, I clear my energy and ground all day long. But there are plenty of people that this reading will resonate with. So please try to not disregard or disrespect the people that are hurting. You know, we are a family here and we try to be kind to one another. So if the reading doesn't resonate with you, you know, try to be understanding for the people that it does resonate with. Last but not least. Guys, these readings could be energy in or around you. So this could be something you're going through, something your person's going through, or it could be, you know, something that a close friend or family member is going through. This could also be, you know, it is intended to be love, but this could also be for a friend or a family member, okay? It could be, you know, anybody that you care about, okay? All right, guys, let's go ahead and get started with your reading, and I hope you guys enjoy. All right, my beautiful loves, let's see what we have here for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. We're going to go ahead and start with some channeled messages. I'm sorry, guys, I just had like the worst coughing fit ever. So we're going to start with some channeled messages. We're going to do a couple of oracle cards and then get into the reading, okay? If you'd like to follow me on TikTok, the link is below. All right, so my loves, what I picked up for you guys is there may have been, again, these are intended to be love readings, but it could be friends, family members, love. You know, love comes in all shapes and forms, right, guys? There was someone here, Cancer, that I feel was talking very negatively behind your back. Somebody here almost wanted to, like, get back at you or, like, I'll show you type of energy, right? You know, this may have been going on for some time. Okay, this may have been going on for some time. But I feel, Cancer, that you powered through it. You know what I'm saying? Like, someone here maybe was trying to hurt your life or sabotage your life in some way, shape, or form. But you powered right through it. You stayed steady. You stayed on course. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, let's just say, for instance, you were trying to open a business. Someone here was going around bad-mouthing you and your business, okay? But you just let it slide right off your shoulders and you just stayed persistent, stayed steady. And Cancer, if this hasn't happened yet, this is your advice for the future to just, if you see anyone attacking you, like if you're going to the gym, if you're starting a business, if you're in a relationship, if you see people talking crap about you or trying to start drama in your life some way, shape, or form, do not let it affect you. Just stay on course. Just stay on course. I promise you, everybody reaps what they sow. You see what I'm saying, Cancer? So if you just stay focused on what you need to stay focused on, you will get the benefits of that. And those people that were trying to cause drama in your life, Well, it'll come back to them. You see what I'm saying? So you just focus on you, Cancer, okay? let's go ahead and pull some oracle here. Clarity, guidance, love messages for my beautiful Cancers, please. Tell me about Cancer. So we've got, it's time to take action, be bold, and make the first move. So Cancer, I feel like this person that's hurting you, or these people that's hurting you, maybe feel like it's time for them to take action, okay, in trying to hurt your life in some way, shape, or form. You may find that they're very bold and maybe even getting more courageous to actually be like letting it be known that it's them talking about you or trying to hurt your life in some way, shape, or form. Or Cancer, this may be an indication that it's time for you to take action and possibly start protecting your life in some way, shape, or form. So let's see what we have here. Clarity, guidance, love messages for my Cancers, please. Tell me about Cancer. So we've got sixth chakra, and we've got the garden and the gate. Second chakra. Okay. So Cancer, I feel like what's happening here is your intuition is telling you that these are people that are just unhappy with themselves, okay? These are people that are just unhappy with themselves. So you're dealing with people that want to harm your success, where, you know, whether that's in a positive relationship, maybe you're trying to have a child, maybe you're opening a business, maybe you started going to the gym, like, you know, whatever you're trying to do and accomplish in your life, you're dealing with someone, or maybe multiple someones, that instead of taking that time and energy and bettering themselves, they want to sit in the place where they're unhappy. Because you see how this person is in that garden? And even though it's a beautiful garden, you see how unhappy this person is? This person can walk out the gate. They can go pursue whatever would make them happy. Instead, they choose to stay in that garden and just hate on people that are actually putting the work into going out and living their lives. You understand? So Cancer, these are people, and I feel like your intuition is, you're operating from your higher self. I feel like you're starting to realize that, you know what, hurt people, you know what I'm saying? So Cancer, if these people are attacking your life, your relationship in some way, shape, or form, I feel like you're just of an energy of, I'm so sorry for whoever hurt you or whatever you have going on inside of you, I'm so sorry. Like, I don't even feel like you're taking it personally. We've got fear. And we've got great gratitude, your higher self. You see what I'm saying? I feel, Cancer, that I feel like you have a choice. You can live in fear of these people that are trying to hurt your life, or you can appreciate them because they are guiding you to be your higher self. So you can bicker back with these people. You can, attempt to, you know, flip out or attempt to get involved and get sucked into it. You know what I'm saying? Or with great gratitude, you could be like, I'm thankful that I'm not like you. I'm thankful that, you know what I'm saying, I've worked on myself and I'm not lowering myself to this level, okay? So let's just say in a love context, Cancer, you're dealing with somebody that maybe, you know, you're split up with this person and maybe like they're dating multiple people and really rubbing it in your face type of thing. And you're just sitting here like, you know what? I'm sorry for you. I'm sorry that, you know what I'm saying, you know, that you're like this, you know what I'm saying? I'm sorry that you think that dating, you know, 20 men or 20 women can never replace me. I'm sorry that you feel that way. I'm sorry that you're putting up this whole big show thinking that you're going to hurt me when in fact the only person you're hurting is yourself, you know? It's just you're operating from a different level here, Cancer. Like, instead of feeding into it and you also, you know, seeking revenge and going to date other people, you're just like, I'm sorry. Sorry that you're like this. You know what I'm saying? Clarity, guidance, love messages for Cancer. Clarity, guidance, love messages for Cancer. Clarity, guidance, love messages for Cancer. So we have girl with a snake, empath, and narcissist paradon, being charmed or used, enable boundaries. So, Cancer, you may be an empath dealing with a narcissist, okay? And I feel like, Cancer, what's happening here is you're done being used by this person. You're done being charmed by this person because that's ultimately what the empath-narcissist relationship is about. You know, they reel you in, use you, toss you away, right? So, Cancer, you're ascending. You're learning the lessons here and you're putting up those boundaries. We've got the chaser. Chaser in a codependent relationship, fear of abandonment issues. And then we have ascending in the reverse. Transcending obstacles, learning expansion, new phase, and preparing for union. Cancer, the lesson that you've learned is chasing after this person out of fear because you're afraid of losing this person is over. It's stopping your ascension. It's stopping you from being your better self. You've come to realize that chasing after this person or these people or this relationship or this situation is causing you to operate from lower vibrations, from places of jealousy, from places of anger, from places that you don't want to be, places that you don't want to be. So it's stopping you from ascending and operating from your highest self, okay? And you're done with that. That's the lesson that you're learning here. You're putting up your boundaries. Tell me about Cancer, please. And tell me about Cancer. Finances and career in the reverse. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. We've got stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. That is also in the reverse. And calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you together in the reverse. So, Cancer, I feel like what's happening here is you're dealing with someone that possibly doesn't want to work on the connection. You may even be dealing with someone that doesn't help out financially either, but they don't want to put any work into the connection. You're losing hope in this person and in this connection. And you're starting to realize that maybe this is not the person. This is not your soulmate. This is not the person you've manifested. This is not the person that you're meant to be with, or that this person is stopping you from manifesting. Cancer, I feel like we've got forgiving and learning under the deck. As you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments. Children, past life relationship, and separation with reconciliation. So, Cancer, I feel like once you truly let go of this, I feel like this person is going to come back around. They're going to want to start a new beginning with you. But Cancer, I feel like you're moving on. You realize that this is unrequited love. You realize that there's nothing here. And again, you know what I'm saying? People will always reap what they sow. They wanted to play these stupid mind games. They wanted to play all this stuff. And now you're moving on with lessons learned, leveling up and ascending. And they're still in the same spot, doing the same stuff, still sitting there in that garden, miserable with their lives. Do you understand? Repeating the same patterns. My nose is so stuffy. I think it's allergies. It's like all stuck behind my nose. All right, let's see here. Clarity. Guidance, love messages for my beautiful Cancers, please. Tell me about Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. What does Cancer need to know today, please, Spirit? So we've got the King of Pentacles, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy, and we have the Six of Wands. Tell me about Cancer, please, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. We've got the Chariot in the reverse, Cancerian energy, and the King of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy. Under the deck, we've got the Eight of Pentacles. So, Cancer, I feel like you were very okay, well, someone here, this could be your side, their side, I don't know. But I feel like someone here was perhaps maybe the breadwinner in the relationship. One person made more money. It could be that this person was just more solid, stable, grounded, responsible in the connection, looking for a future, planning that future. But with the Chariot in the reverse, someone here was realizing that this is just not a good decision. It's not a good decision to waste all my time and energy into something that's just not succeeding, okay? Now, with the Six of Wands and the King of Cups, you may have something new coming in, Cancer. You may have, you know what I'm saying, this King of Cups energy, someone that's very loving, loyal, romantic. You know, you may have someone coming in here that your time, energy, love, money would be better spent on. With the Eight of Pentacles under the deck and the Page of Swords, Aquarius, Gemini, Libra energy here, there's an awakening here. There's an understanding of where you should spend your time and energy into. Now, also with the Eight of Pentacles, Cancer, you may have been doing, because the Eight of Pentacles can also talk about studying. So you guys may have started your spiritual journey. You guys may be, you know, trying to find information or talking to someone who's wiser than you, or learning from someone who's wiser than you, how to ascend, how to handle these things with grace. Tell me about the King of Pentacles here for Cancer. King of Pentacles for Cancer. We've got the Nine of Swords, and we've got the Tower, Aries, Scorpionic energy. Cancer, someone here was really trying to be a husband or a wife to someone or to a situation that just wasn't positive. With the Nine of Swords and the Tower, someone here was constantly living in fear, anxiety, despair, not being able to sleep at night, having nightmares, you know, always thinking the worst about the connection, knowing that with the Tower, something isn't quite right and everything that you're building is gonna fall. You understand? So someone here knows that. They know that this person was in this relationship understanding that. Tell me about the Chariot in the reverse, please. Tell me about the Chariot in the reverse. So we've got the Eight of Wands in the reverse, and we have the Ace of Cups. Cancer, I feel like someone here is moving towards new love. We've got the Strength card, the Four of Wands, and the Six of Wands. Someone here may be moving towards something way more stable, a divine counterpart, possibly twin flame, doesn't have to be. I mean, twin flames, it can be very chaotic. If you guys don't meet each other at the right time, twin flames could be super chaotic. So with this Four of Wands, I do see it sometimes as just a divine counterpart, someone that mirrors you, someone that has the same goals, aspirations, equal give and take in love, someone who wants the same future as you. You know what I'm saying? Like two people that maybe want to go and, you know, just buy an RV and travel the world together, or, you know, somebody that want, you know what I'm saying? They have the same values and they see the world the same way. Yeah, I feel like you're tired. You're tired of dealing with someone who's irresponsible, someone here that just wants to be carefree, that doesn't want to settle down, someone non-committal. Cancer, you're moving on to something new here. Six of Wands and the Hierophant, Taurus energy. This is a beautiful new committed relationship. Tell me about this King of Cups and the Five of Swords. Cancer, this is the mind games. This is the sabotage. This is what I was feeling in your message at the beginning of the reading. So, Cancer, I feel like someone here doesn't like that you're moving on. Someone here does not like that you're moving on. And I feel like someone here is going to come and try to throw a grenade in that, okay? And again, that could be the person that you were dealing with, friend, family member. You go ahead and take that as it resonates, okay? Clarity, guidance, and love messages for my Cancers, please. Clarity, guidance, love messages for my Cancers, please. Oh, oh, oh. Got it. Okay. The Wheel of Fortune. The Two of Pentacles, the Five of Pentacles, and the Ace of Swords. Under the deck, we've got the Magician and the Nine of Wands. and the Six of Swords. Okay, Virgo, Gemini energy. So, Cancer, here we go. With the Wheel of Fortune and the Five of Pentacles, the wheel is turning on this person, Cancer. You reap what you sow. You reap what you sow. So we're dealing with someone here who's now either financially desolate, because I'm seeing King of Pentacles to the Five of Pentacles. So Cancer, the person on this side, it doesn't have to be, but may have been the breadwinner. Okay, someone here may have, you know what I'm saying, been paying for everything. You might be dealing with someone here who's financially desolate, someone here who's constantly, you know, living in fear, someone here who doesn't have anything, someone who's just been shut out, left out, you know, and that's it. With the Two of Pentacles and the Ace of Swords here, I feel like this person's life is all over the place. Their life is just all over the place. They don't know which way to turn to get money or where to live. You know, Two of Pentacles, you know, up, down, their life is just all over the place, you know. And with the Ace of Swords, I feel like there's an awakening. I feel like there's an awareness that someone here manifested this. So we've got the Magician, we've got the Nine of Wands, and we've got the Six of Swords. So I feel like someone here, is perhaps coming in, Cancer, wanting to stop you from leaving. I feel like we have someone here that perhaps wants to stop you from moving on. Because they're realizing here that doing you wrong has brought a lot of negativity into their life. Yep. They're realizing here that by hurting you, they've only hurt themselves. Tell me about the Wheel of Fortune for Cancer. Tell me about the Wheel of Fortune for Cancer. The Seven of Cups. Tell me about the Five of Pentacles for Cancer, the Three of Pentacles. Tell me about the Two of Pentacles, the Judgment card, Sagittarian energy. And tell me about this Ace of Swords and the Knight of Wands. So, Cancer, I feel like this person thought that whatever they were doing to you was going to work. This person thought that whatever they were doing to you was going to work. And now that everything's turning on them, they're like, oh my gosh, what is going on? Do you understand what I'm saying? What is going on? Now they're like, I wonder if Cancer will give me a second chance. They're going to take action and come, you know what I'm saying, and come towards you. Yeah, see, now they're looking in, you know, you're in a relationship, you're in a new relationship, and now the snake is coming back. Do you understand? Now they're realizing, oh no, you know what? I do want Cancer. I do want to work on this. I don't want to let Cancer go. I don't want Cancer to leave me. And look at this, you've got the same three cards. Nine of Wands, Six of Swords, Five of Pentacles. Those were the same three cards we pulled before. Someone here just doesn't want you to go. They're trying to block forward movement because they're jealous of the new beginning. They're jealous of the new person. They're jealous of where you're heading in life. They're jealous of where you're going. So, Cancer, you're dealing with someone here that did you dirty, and you're simply releasing, you're simply letting go, because this person, you know what I'm saying, just serves, you know, when I say serves no purpose in your life, I don't mean to be dismissive or egoistic when I say that. What I mean is we're all on a journey. We're all on a spiritual journey. You know, some people come into our lives to just teach us a lesson, and then it's not meant for them to stay. And when I say that, I mean that this person, as you could see here with these cards, this person has taught you not to waste your time on energy. You're ascending. Don't regress. You know what I'm saying? Don't allow someone to pull you back down. This is someone who's obviously operating from a very low vibration. This is someone who doesn't want to learn their lessons, doesn't want to do the right thing to help themselves. And they're on their own spiritual journey. So, Cancer, you're doing what you have to do to release. You're letting go and moving on with your spiritual ascension. Tell me about the challenge here for Cancer. We've got the Two of Swords, the Nine of Swords, and the King of Wands, Leo, Sag, Aries energy. The challenge here, Cancer, is that you're destroying this person's ego. You're destroying their ego. This is someone who is always able to get what they want, whether it's through sex or looks or flirting or charming their way in, as we discussed previously at the beginning of the reading. And they're being blocked. And now this person is having a very hard time because their usual tricks are not working. Okay, their usual way of getting you back is not working because you're not chasing this anymore. You have come to the realization that it's time to release. Tell me about the outcome here for Cancer. Tell me about the outcome here for Cancer. We've got the Three of Cups. We've got the Page of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy, and the Eight of Wands with the Ace of Wands here. Cancer, you're going to have, I feel, two different people coming towards you. I feel one new, one old. But with the Page of Cups here, definitely an apology coming in. Definitely a lot of communication coming in. Someone here, Cancer, really wants to reconcile. And this could also be a representation that there's someone new that is sweet on you wanting to move forward, okay? So let's go ahead and take this into the extended. Let's see what we have happening with the new, with the old, what else spirit wants you to know, what other messages there are, and we'll just continue on, okay? I love you guys. The link for the extended is in the description box below and in the comment section below. Take care, my loves.